subscribe, like, and turn on bell notifications to be notified of my uploads.
Hi, and in this video, we're gonna be making our player move. So what I've done, I've created a new folder in my assets. I called it script, and in here I made a new script called player, and I attached it to my player. Oh, so let's just start coding. So we want to have the ability to fine tune our player speed. We can change it however we would like. So what I will do is I'll create a new serialized field. So create a new serialized field, private float, and you can call it whatever you want. I'll just call it move speed, and I'll set it default to 5. And now, because we want our player to move based on physics and velocities, we're gonna be using the rigid body. So I'll create a private rigid body 2D, rigid body 2D, because that's the one that we've attached onto our player, and I'll call this RB. And here in the start method, whenever the game starts, we want reference to what our rigid body is. So we can do RB, oh god, not here. We can do RB is equal to get component. And here we can pass in the type, which is rigid body 2D. I'll copy that and paste it in here. And remember, get component only gets a component attached onto the game object. So if you don't have a rigid body 2D attached onto your player or whatever the script is attached to, this line will throw an error. And now for update, I'll create a new function, and I'll call it move, not move speed, move. And now functions are just ways of calling code collectively. So anything inside this move function gets called in update. Right, so if I'll create private void move, not on animator move, I just want it to be move. And now what we can do is here we can say, because we just remember we're using the old input system, so we might want our players to use the arrow keys or the AD keys to move left and right. And we don't want to do if checks, like if input, and remember for the old input system, it's input.get key, get button, get access, which we will be covering in a few seconds. Get key down, and you pass in key code.a. And you write the code for every time someone presses A, and then you want to write the code for every time someone presses D, someone presses left arrow, someone presses right arrow, and that's very inefficient. And also, it's not performant. So an easier way to do this is using the input manager, but in a much easier way. So we can create a float, call this the move direction or move dir, and we set this equal to input dot get axis raw, and this takes in an axis name, and there's the two major types, which is horizontal, which is the left arrow key, right arrow key, A and D, or vertical, which is WS and up and down. But I think for left and right, we should go for horizontal. And now, because it's a 2D game, we're going to create a vector 2, and we'll call this velocity to apply. And this velocity will be calculated every frame, and it will be applied every time the get axis horizontal is pressed. So we can say this is equal to a new vector 2, and vector 2 takes in an x and y value. So for the x value, which is left and right, and because this is a platformer, I think left and right is the one we need to edit. So for the x value, we're passing the move direction. And we'll multiply that by the move speed. And then for the y value, we can just give the velocity dot y. We can get the y velocity. And then we need to apply this velocity. So we can say rb dot velocity is equal to velocity to apply. There we go. And this should be as simple as that. if I were to hit play. Okay, his laptop's a little glitchy as of right now, it's fine. So if I were to hit the right arrow keys, I'm moving to the right. If I were to hit the left arrow key, I'm moving to the left. Hit A, I'm moving to the left. B, I'm moving to the left. That's very cool. And now, in the next video, we will be implementing jumping and flipping the character sprite so it matches the direction we're going. Alright, see you there.